Guys, welcome back to another one of my long YouTube videos. Chef! I have all my subscriptions. I actually forgot I was subscribed to this guy. And I forgot I was subscribed to this guy too. I actually haven't looked at Chris Facts in a while. Shorts.
The saddest ship sinkings.
But before, make sure to like and subscribe if you think that this dog is cute.
The saddest plane crashes.
But before, make sure to like and subscribe if you think that this dog is cute.
YouTube, I've sorted my last 12 months, and you can. This shows me all of my most popular videos from the last 12 months. Oh, brilliant. But if you start scrolling all the way down really, 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 really far, we get to random videos that you guys have made about me, and I'm going to watch through them, and I'm sure that most of them will be terrible, but here we go. Okay, let's start with best YouTubers in 2022. Excited for this. I've not watched this. I don't know what position I am, but I must be included for it to have shown up. Okay. Super Mario Logan, Mr. Beast, oh my god. Wait. If I'm last, that means that I came first, right? Editor Kai, edit in the numbers. Okay, who's next? Who's the next favourite? Who's it gonna be? Oh, it's me. That's number one, right? Is there anyone else? Wait. It is, yes! Jack sucks at life empire, then versus now. So, here's Becky. And then, what's the next one? Becky now. Oh, the picture was like 2 years ago. I was like, very pretty there, holding Mr. Beast 100 million players. Oh, Flossie, okay. Well, let's see Flossie now. I mean, to be fair, that was 2018. I think this is from like the last year. Flossie's 17 years old. She is looking well. Kong then. Kong now. Oh, Kong's gone grey. Once again, that picture wasn't from long ago. Kai then. Kai now. Oh, Kai from 2 years ago. Wait, where am I? It's my bloody empire. Who am I? Come on, in it. Daniel Strow uploaded Jack Sucks at Life's channel's race to 100k. Right, this should be quite interesting, so... Don't subscribe, got there in just 1 hour from 0 to 100,000. That's actually mental. And then, next fastest, interesting. Jack's up a YouTube channel full of fun, Sam's fun, Harry Kiss. I got there in 12 hours. You know what? I don't even remember, like, how we launched that channel. But 12 hours, there we go. And Turd Boy, it looks like, was a close second. Turd Boy, well, it's all going on, hang on. And then it looks like Turd Boy and then the longer channel name, they were a close second. They were 24 hours from 0 to 100k. Jack Sucks at Clips took 2 days, okay. Oh, we're reaching day 5. Jackson's Upon Pirate and Geography, they took a week. So it's so interesting seeing this, because on some of my channel launches, I was trying to get as many subscribers as possible in like the shortest amount of time, like don't subscribe. Whereas No Context Jackson's to Life, on the other hand, I only ever promoted that channel on Jackson's stuff, because it was just like a little fun side project, not something I really wanted to like make a success. And then Jackson's stuff was launched way back in 2019, before I got known for like getting channels to 100k, so that was how long it took. Now look at that, week four. Month two. It took 2 months. 4 months for the Spanish channel. No way did it take 6 months for Jackson's stuff to get to 100k. Just 100k. Look, I understand 100k is a lot, but like when you think about Don't Subscribe getting there in like 30 minutes, that's kind of mental. And then AJ Saf, it says it.
Go say hi. Video is your presentation, darling.
Cats are a mystery. Their health shouldn't be.
Welcome to this month's Jackson's Geography Writer video. If you want to join 34,000 others and for some information to react to next week, then the link is at the top of the description. This month's top post, someone was rude and wrote the N-word on my school sidewalk. I decided to change that. Oh, so you've changed the N-word to just saying Nigeria and it's just got a little Nigerian flag. That's so good. You did the right thing. Agreed. Also agreed. I agree with this statement. Oh, that's pretty cute, isn't it? The Seychelles flag combined with many others. Okay, enhance, enhance. The actual Seychelles flag has Romania's three colours and then Hungary's three colours. But following that logic, we could also make Belgium and Luxembourg, which looks really striker. That's pretty cool. Italy and Austria, okay. France and Luxembourg, yeah, that works alright. Netherlands and Belgium works well. The black and the yellow in Belgium.
Hello. Stand out. Come look at this cute dog over here in her natural habitat. In her natural habitat.
There, Dorothy is in her natural habitat, huh? Big gray furry rug. And there's a squirrel in its natural habitat.
Yeah,
a little bird.
Look at that, it's literally impossible. I got a flag phone case. Oh,
okay, well,
that is epic. I need me one of those.
I
got about to name
nice
every
clean,
single
honey.
Flag. I'll just get a bunch wrong and you'll all make
nice
put me in the comments.
Clean.
No. Wait a minute, what? So you evaluated my face, and apparently I look 42% Indian, 42% Jewish, 8% Qatari, and 8% Vatican. Well, that's really accurate. But you realise Captain America's suit doesn't have 50 stars, so he's actually Captain Puerto Rico. Yeah, technically makes sense to me. The world if the bottom flags were chosen instead. Oh, I love these two Australia and New Zealand mock-ups. Particularly the New Zealand one. I'm not so sure about the Canada one. I feel like Canada's flag's pretty good. What's your favourite African flag?
Ooh,
now it's a tricky one. Obviously, I really do love the Seychelles, so I would have to go with that. But what about continental Africa? The South African flag's really cool. I definitely like the Ethiopian flag. I even like the Central African Republic flag. I just think there's something really nice about that. Let's see what you all said. Seychelles, South Africa, and Botswana. Yeah, fair enough. Unpopular opinion, the Sierra Leone flag, which is this one for your reference. I like the colours. Yeah, I know what you mean. Cape Verde. Ooh, here's the Cape Verde flag. Side note, Kai, who edits these geography videos, must have so many flags saved to his downloads folder. Yeah, the Cape Verde flag is alright. I would pick it as one of my faves. Seychelles, no competition.
Yeah, it's a very nice flag, isn't it?
Jack's saying that Mozambique is the only country that has every vowel. Jack, when he finally realizes Democratic Republic of Congo, Equatorial Guinea, Dominican Republic all have every vowel as well. Yeah, I know. I think I've acknowledged this already. So I got the stat wrong. It's not that it's got every vowel. It's that it's got every vowel only once. There's an O, there's an A, there's an I, there's a U, and there's an E. I need to remember that because, you know, I should not be spreading misinformation on my platform, and I'm sorry that I did that. Oh my god, this was my 5-year-old's birthday cake request. That is incredible. A Seychelles-St. Lucia combo. Oh god. Needed something to do on summer break, so I drew Europe. Well, you did a much, much better job than I did when I tried to draw Europe. I reckon your UK looks a bit big, but other than that, very nice. Speaking of the UK, some delightful attention to detail on Northern Ireland's little bit lining up with the rest of the flag. Oh, if this post gets 998 upvotes, Jack will do all 197 countries and donate £50 every mispronunciation. Oh, I would have loved to, but unfortunately, oh, look at that. It only got 230, so I can't do it now. Oh, never mind. I tell you what, though, if you want to post some geography challenges that I can do from my computer, maybe I will attempt the top post of the next Jackson's Geography Radio video. Guess where I'm from? Oh, my God, there's a building on fire. All right, well, ignoring that, I'll have a go. This registration plate's the key. It's somewhere in the EU, isn't it? I mean, it could just be the Republic of Ireland. Fair. The cars all look very much like the cars that I'm used to seeing in the UK, as does the buildings. Yeah, I'm just going to submit Ireland. It is Ireland, yeah! The people in the comments are actually guessing the specific towns in Ireland as opposed to just the country as a whole, so that's really kind of humbled me. I'm trying to paint every country flag on rocks. I have 8 so far. What do you all think? I think you've done an absolutely delightful job. You said you were painting some flags onto rocks, and that is exactly what you've done. Your Bangladesh flag does look like an olive, though. How to say shut up in Europe? Okay, so in the UK, it's shut up. In Germany, it's halt die Klappe. In France, it's das Doi. In Spain, it's Galette. In Portugal, it's Galici. In Ireland, it's stop to stuss. In Norway, it's hold kjeft. In Sweden, it's halkleften. In Finland, it's herbakini. In Russian, it's zatkins. And in Turkey, it's sus. What is the first word that comes to mind when I say Canada? Okay, one word, maybe maple for maple leaf, or maybe moose potentially. For me, it's sorry. Yeah, sorry is like a bit of a stereotype, isn't it? Maple syrup, there we go. Canada, fair enough. As a half American, I'm so tired of everyone making fun of us for being bad at geography. There are Americans who are good at geography too. To prove it, I named all the countries of Europe, and they're all completely wrong with you. Why have you put chicken instead of turkey? The Antarctica flag emoji needs to be changed. So this is what the flag of Antarctica looks like, but actually its official flag is this. That's weird. Get it sorted out, man, Apple. Wake up. The biggest scam in history. Yeah, so Greenland isn't really very green, and Iceland isn't really that icy. I mean, I know if you're actually there, they both have bits of green and bits of ice. But overall, looking at it from a height, yeah, they need to swap. Can you guess the country? Ooh, here we go. They have a population of 2 million, which is over 22 full Wembley stadiums. That's not very many. That doesn't narrow it down. I need more clues. It is thought to have made the first wooden wheel. The wheel was over 5,000 years old. Ooh, so I'm thinking maybe with that kind of age, it could be like around the Middle East area. I don't know. Well, let's keep going. It's in the Northern Hemisphere. Right, okay. It's one of the cleanest countries in the world. It's scored 96 out of 100 in sustainability indicators. So that's going to rule out a bunch of third world countries. I'm thinking somewhere in Europe maybe at the moment. But population 2 million. This is hard. I'm not smart enough for this. It's 20,000 kilometers squared in size, which is around the same size as New Jersey. So that could be Europe, I guess. This country's been part of the EU, so we now know it's definitely in Europe. The country shares borders with 4 other countries. Make your final guess before the country is revealed. The mystery country is... Oh, and there's a little drum. That's nice. Okay, borders for the countries. I kind of want to say Denmark, maybe? That feels like the right kind of size, maybe. But the first wooden wheel, does that sound right? We'll go with it. Let's try it. Slovenia! First wooden wheel thought to have come from Slovenia. That was good. Well, I'd do more of them. Vision for Jack to make 2 Jackson's Geography Radio videos per month. I would, but the posts aren't actually good enough right now. That's why I literally just do it every 4 weeks. So if you want me to make more of these videos, I need you to join the Reddit and post some interesting things that are like original. Don't just Google geography memes and put them on here. Make your own stuff or make stuff related to videos that I've done recently. You know what I mean? Oh, I took the Jackson's Geography Globe I won on a walk. Guess where I'm from? Yes, it arrived. So I gave this away, what, 3 months ago? And it's quite rare when I give something away that people like let me know it's arrived. So this is so nice to see. Look at that, a signed Jackson's Geography Globe. I mean, I literally wrote down the address, so I know roughly where this...
kind of buy some intel, loot location, security tips, tenant routines. The Joneses, we're going to be trying to keep up with the Joneses. They look like they've got some money, dude. I'm down. It's possible to climb to the second floor on Vine's lattice. It's a pricey guitar in the garage. There's only one person between 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. I mean, I'm down to try to get in there. Let's get it, boys. One person from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., so we should actually, take a little nap here. I'm gonna sleep to 8 a.m. on the dot. We're gonna have a daytime robbery, boys. Ready to start her up? We're gonna head back to Greenfield. So 104 is gonna be on this main road.
Your reading is super powerful. So stop straining your eyes and start listening instead.
Talk to a lot. This is it right here. Alright. So we're gonna find a parking spot for the whip. Honestly. I'm not worried about it. This is 104. There's one person home and they're sleeping. I don't think we need climbing gloves. We're gonna be able to get those with this next ability. Did we just pick the lock to the front door? Mini electric lock pick required. We may not even be able to get in this thing, dude. We can get in here. Let's try it. We're not gonna give it up. At least not yet. We got somebody on the street. I mean, I'm down to get balls. Step up security and stuff over time, but that just worked, bro. All right, we're gonna take this thing back to the pawn shop. Or actually, we may check to see if it's on Black Bay, but if not, we're gonna take it back to the pawn shop. We're gonna see what this thing's worth. We got a 1-star for this stealth, boys, but I'm not too upset about it. Got new hints available. All right, I want to see if there's anything here on Black Bay for what would be under? Other old Yamaha guitar? Missing required items. Alright. Oh, lots of art and stuff as well. So we're going to take this thing to the pawn shop. Yeah, that's typically not how you want to run a job, but we had no other way into that house. It was a house that we probably shouldn't have gone to yet, but we were already there, so we had to give it a go, man. Let's see.
Welcome back.
Let's see what this is worth. $220. I'll sell it, boy. Okay, so on Rent-A-Thug, we've got to break or steal the pear decoration. We're going to accept that. And then we've got this same house, 113, the Powells. We're going to buy the intel. Printer worth a lot in the living room. No one home from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Spare key for the front door in the bedroom. All right, that's good. The Powells, Not home at all day. It's gonna cost you, man. It's unfortunate, but 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. we know we're good. Actually, we should probably sleep through the night. Give us a full day to work. Okay. So we're gonna sleep through to 9 a.m. and then we're gonna head that way. 113, baby. We are making our way to 113. So this is gonna be awesome because we're getting paid for kind of like our side gig, our hustler gig. We're also gonna get paid for that valuable printer. And we've got a little bit of everything happening here. Can we just park in the driveway? You know what I mean? Maybe not the best idea, so we're gonna park up here, hopefully out of view of people. It'd be cool if you could just park in the driveway, act like you're the normal person, you know what I mean? But I guess neighbors would know that you're not normal at all. Alright, here we go, let me quit. The good news is we know that nobody's home. There's the spare key. Alarm clock? I think I'm gonna hold off for now. So this is the house that we were kind of in before, very briefly. Car. There. Check one more here. There. Were we in this house or is this a different one? Oh shoot, we're gonna have to lockpick this. Sorry, I was looking at the notes over on the right-hand side. I want to make sure we got plenty of time before they're home. We do. Alright, so we're definitely going to want the money over everything else. Money over here. These people are freaking balling, dude. They've got a beautiful home. Cash just sitting all over the place. There's the printer that we're going to take. And they've got a TV. We got money in here, too. We're gonna make sure we get all the big stuff, and then we're gonna come back and show Maha receiver. Inventory is full, so we gotta pick this thing up, and we gotta find a way to get this thing to the car. Dude. Good news is the key, the front door is unlocked because we have the key. A no key? What is that? Like a phone? I guess if we take these alarm clocks, we'll take the alarm clocks.
So to help you remember that Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance, here's a touching moment.
Liberty Mutual? It's perfect.
Only pay for what you need.
Alexa saying, hey James, loving the Tash by the way, thank you, I've not had it like the pictures so far this year, but it's making a comeback this very month, in fact. You're right on time. How many times on the daily do you get Alexa jokes? It must be pretty rough. So many. I'm at the point of wanting to sue Jeff Bezos for ruining my life. Aha. Even the postman made an Alexa joke the other day. Aha. Oh no. That's so sad. Play Despacito. Send me a SpongeBob quote if you're real. You can't just ask me for pictures. Do I look like fake to you? Then I'm fake. Bye. Damn. Which episode of SpongeBob is that quote from? You know Sugma? No. Sugma Nuts? Do you know Joe Mama? No, Joe Rogan. Who's Joe Rogan? You stupid prick. I know a name of a good plastic surgeon. Hit me up. I can get you 10% off. I know a good dietitian. But I'm afraid if I tell you that name, you'll eat them. Chonky. Haha, well, how do you feel about a bald girl? Well, I'm not sure. Depends on the girl. Oh, I'm currently deaf. I'd love to see how it looks. It's going to be a huge burden on your shoulders. No more worries about messy hair days. Haha, I mean, it's not good for a reason. I have cancer. It's not totally off yet. I'm waiting to get a shave. But yeah, it's a lot easier. Oh, wow.
OMG, please teach me how to longboard.
Sure, lol. Would I be able to hold your hands while you balance?
Okay, that's really cute, but I would 1000% fall on you.
Oh, baby.
It's okay. I'm juicy and will break your fall.
Ahahaha. Lamel, no, I'm 5'8". I would crush you. Wow, she's under 6 foot. Unmatch her right now, bro. Alright, a message from Dick Cheney on Facebook seems legit. Hey, are you legal? Do you have your papers? No, I'm ready, please. You're getting deported. Oh, dear. Something quite odd about having Dick Cheney on Facebook, right? Like, how do you have this guy as your Facebook friend?
Yeah. What you gonna eat?
Stewed cabbage. I love cabbage. You need to love that new German. Ah, I guess I'm lucky I'm not German. Wait, why?
I love cabbage.
I don't really like cabbage.
Wait, what? Besides...
Oh! I'm sorry, baby, I failed you. So, bees are the reason we have flowers, right? Now, the bees only keep the flowers growing, so we can use them as gifts, such as on dates. Now we have to have dates in order to fall in love and have children and reproduce, correct? That means the bees are the reason we are alive, and slaves to the birds. Now, if anyone asks if you know about reproduction, you can say yes. You know about the birds. See, I'm a treasure trove of information. Take me to coffee and I'll spend 2 hours telling you about how the government just wants to know that ducks are lakes are free and you can just take them home. Okay, no, because I knew that one. We would spend 2 hours formulating a plan to steal all the resources. Bruh, I never thought about this, but yeah, I guess you could just nab a duck. Don't actually do that though, guys. Hey Dad, I just got a girlfriend and she's pregnant.
What's the matter with you? Are you proud? When you get home, you're in so much freaking trouble. Your mom already knows that she's devastated. Who's this scrap, you idiot?
Tab, I meant perfect, not pregnant. I'm so sorry. It's this damn phone. Autocorrected me.
Oh gosh. You just made me piss my pants, son. I broke your laptop.
What the frick, Dad? Wow, you've been done savage by autocorrect, bro.
You meant to just say... Hey Dad, I got a girlfriend and she's perfect.
Instead says pregnant, and now his MSI gaming laptop worth $5,000 has been destroyed. Can we get 2 likes, guys? Message to Mothership. Need to get the Wi-Fi fixed in college for my classes.
Oh shoot, yeah, no cap. Oh my gosh.
Ah, oh, bruh. Lol, this is a moment. Yep, for you. I'm laughing. How tall are you? Why? I only date tall guys. 6'3". How much do you weigh?
What the frick?
Why? I don't date overweight girls. Wow, you're a misogynistic pig, judging women. I hope you die alone.
Kazuma had never seen somebody before.
Yeah, you can't really be getting mad at guys for asking you their weight when you're asking for their height, like...
Really, bruh?
Freaking misogynistic pigs. After a time, someone asked, how much will a brain cost?
The doctor quickly responded,
$5,000 for a male brain. $200 for a female brain.
Take from this what you will, but this is the top Google result. This truly says a lot about our society.
I'm mostly about them lungs.
You can sell them each for like 800,000. It's really free money. I mean, you don't need two, right?
I know, right? I'm becoming a millionaire for selling both my lungs, apparently. I sold my brain too after all those spelling mistakes.
Ah, just buy an iron lung with the money, you know.
Ooh!
You can breathe in that loads of cash.
Those are cheap, right?
With a good price, I can buy two lungs. Still have a mil.
I'm actually, like, so curious where this study came from. That is $5,000 for a male brain, but $200 for a female brain.
This is disgraceful.
What's scary about this image?
Nothing. What should be scary? If my hand wasn't in the way, you would have seen my dick. No joke.
No!
What are you doing tonight?
Studying. You?
I like where this is going.
No, I have a huge test tomorrow. It's gonna be long and hard.
Oh, gee, you're so hot.
You over at 10? No, sorry. My texts aren't going through. Hey, seriously, don't mess this up.
Well, shout out to the Illuminati, really helping this guy out here. Like, bro, she really doesn't care that you're advising for a mass exam on Pythagoras' theorem.
Just get over there.
So Steve lists up some free shelves on the Facebook marketplace and says, currently still available. First come, first serve. This black guy goes, where are you located in Oregon? Near Mountain-based State Park.
Is that all you got? Was just them shelves?
Kind of far for a couple of shelves, if you know what I mean.
If you got a couple more things, that'd be cool.
Bro's really just been offered some shelves. For free. Free of charge.
He's like, yo, you got anything else, man? Like, come on, this ain't worth it.
That's unbelievable, bro. Like, you're literally getting it for free.
Die.
Huh?
I don't know. I don't know who you are.
But die. Perish.
Sure.
No, because who are you? Off your ass.
Kind of hot.
This is the weirdest conversation with strangers.
Bruh.
Consider this a freaking warning.
Oh, sorry. Wrong person. Who's the right person? Who the heck is the right person?
Yup.
And a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is that it has the perfect amount of
The continent of Asia, according to Americans.
Find out.
Okay, first of all, I'm already terrified. I've seen plenty of videos of Americans just really...
I'll name five countries in America. North Korea, South Korea, Japan, Mongolia, China.
Embarrassing me about this sort of stuff.
West Korea?
Name five... Okay, West Korea. I've made an identical map to West and East Korea. The West would just be insanely powerful. I guess that assumes the existence of an East Korea.
Thailand?
Where? That seems like an interesting place to visit, that's for sure. Is that why it gets so many? I want to make fun of her for saying we failed our history class as an excuse for not recognizing this flag, but whatever, this is fun. It's right.
That's the name?
Yeah. It's China.
Yes. It's China. That's the thing. I'm guessing. Of stars. The country of stars. Vietnam happens to be the country of star, which is perfect because they're right next to each other.
What country do you think is Asia?
India! India.
Those are the colors of Italy, are they not?
Honestly, I would have let it go. I would have let it go if she saw, like, you know what, I don't know. I don't think I think she's that. Italy. That looks pretty Italian to me. Look, Sicily kind of does look like,
Monkey, what's up?
Yeah.
Ants. Perfect. Yeah. What's up with you over here, little chimpanzee, huh? Little monkey, what are you up to?
Let's go. You know what?
You know, Sebastian up to in here, huh? Birds are eating like little piggies out here. I say the birds are eating like little piggies out here. Let's say what? Birds are pigging out. Okay, that's for when I get the bed all made.
Boofy.
Boofy. Your little buddy's here with you, huh? I'm gonna watch the weather so I can see what the weekend's gonna be like. So you can see what's happening this weekend.
is this. Right, I'm at a random country border somewhere in the world, and I have to work out which country border this is. Oh, there's Brazil. There's Venezuela. A tricky one to begin with. Right, so the Brazilian part of the Venezuelan border is all this area. So I still have to try and work out which of these it is. But at the moment, I'm thinking Pacaramia, because it's in a good spot with a big road. So let's see if we can maybe find that word. It's nice to see a big open border as well, isn't it? No big scary fences.
Oh, but I'm sure later
in this video, there'll be some big scary fences.
We're closing the dryer,
sign over
we're
on this side.
And
what does it say? Hey, 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 take me the other way. That is the worst billboard I've ever seen. Yeah, that's not really giving much away, is it? That is a washed out billboard. Oh, hang on. What we got over this side? Antido or Paracaminos de Carga. That's not necessarily a place name, but let's just look along the border and see if we can see anything that says anything similar. No, it doesn't look like it. Now, if we were down in this town, there'd be kind of signs for Colombia as well, so we'll rule that one out. I'm probably in the right spot. I wonder if we should just guess it. Yeah, let's try it. Guess. Oh, a perfect score to begin with. That means it could only be downhill from here. Let's play the next one, and I am hyped. Oh my god. Oh no, what are you doing to me? This is so rural. There's no signs, there's no flags. I don't know where the border is. So immediately I am thinking Africa, but obviously that could be wrong. There's a cool border in Africa, which is like this, like, it's almost a quad.
Means yeah, back then.
I'm inspired by the Day of the Dead culture here in Los Angeles. I seem to connect a lot of...
dishwashers. 80% less water than hand wash. And save $130 on utilities. Cascade.
From caring for your skin to caring for the Earth's, discover Dove's partnership with Rimba to protect forests.
Damn!
How much were they?
I don't know.
I have a boyfriend.
Yes, that's very relevant to the conversation. What's up, cuties? My name's Vintage, your favorite 10-year-old anime girl. And today we're going to be taking a look at some funny, epic text messages. Message from Mom. Hi, honey. Love you. Your father and I are getting a divorce.
What the frick?
It's one way to find out your parents are splitting up. Crikey. I think the Minions meme was very appropriate. So, is this you?
Yeah, that's me. Your clan dead. Lol.
Wait, didn't you start this clan though? Lol.
I have a question.
I have an answer.
Well, what's the answer?
What's the question? That was the question.
And you got my answer.
Yes.
I would name him the full name though. Moonshadow is cute, but I like human names for cats.
Just me personally.
Ah, Cat Stevens is hidden then. Unless it's something silly like Bean. Like Potato?
Right.
Potato is an acceptable name.
Smokey would not be.
I guess I don't like adjectives as names.
No, honey. That's me.
Subscribe for a year of good luck. Thanks.
Go to McDonald's and try to pay with a check.
Shut it off. I'll call the police.
Happy birthday to you.
When anybody goes to Lily and Sadie, they put you on.
Well, guys, so that's going to be the end of this video, and bye-bye.